What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the SignBoard Minecraft plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Developing a Minecraft server tends to involve displaying useful information to players, such as rules, helpful commands, and other similar details. This can easily turn into a huge wall of signs, which may become harder to read or follow along in-game. Solving this is done through the SignBoard Spigot plugin, allowing players to simply look at a sign or NPC to receive tons of information through a scoreboard popup. Head to SignBoard on Spigot's website and click Download Now to the right-hand side, and then save this file somewhere easily accessible to use in just a minute. Head towards your Apex server panel, stop the server, and make sure you're running a plugin compatible server like Paper or Spigot. After that, you can click FTP file access in the top left, log in, and then find and select the plugins directory and click Upload in the top left corner. On the next page, drag and drop the SignBoard file into the upload area, and once it reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. Most of the plugin's setup is done in-game once it's installed, but it requires you to have operator privileges. There is an alternative method to do the same process, which is creating or editing them in the config file. Craft a sign and place it down with any displayed text that you want. Afterwards, run the SBBoard new name command in chat. By default, there are predefined lines for a new board. Viewing this requires you to apply it on the sign, which is done with SB sign attach name while looking at it. The default lines in the board might be frustrating if you're creating multiple signs, but these can be removed in the plugin's configuration, which we will go over later. After creating a new board, you can start editing its lines. There are lines 1 through 16, starting from the bottom to the top. Editing any of them requires you to use the SBBoard name line X text command. Replace the X with your desired line number, and then you can add the text after it. You can also use color codes to change its basic appearance. If you want to have nothing in one line, then just don't add any text in the command. Do this for every line until you're satisfied with the results, then execute SB sign attach board while looking at it to save the edits. Another feature from SignBoard is adding commands to boards, which can either be executed by the player or the console. Doing this process requires you to look at the sign and then run SB sign interaction command in chat. If you want the command to run as the server's console, then just prefix it with underscore RFC underscore. This example allows the player to change their game mode to survival on click. The placeholder value at the end represents the username of the person clicking the sign. Using custom boards on entities is relatively the same process. Just replace sign with entity in the commands. For example, using SB entity attach name saves and attaches all of the line changes on the target. Due to the complexity of SignBoard commands, we recommend checking out the official Spigot page for the plugin, which will give you more detailed info about which command to use in chat. But here are some of the most important. All of these are going to also need permissions for players to use them, which you can assign through a plugin like Blackperms. Another way to customize your boards is editing the plugin's boards YML config file. This can only be used after creating a sign in-game. There are other files to review too, such as tweaking the default board messages. Head to the FTP file access and log in, and on the next page, enter the plugins and SignBoard directory. Once you're there, press edit to the right of the board's YML file, and on the next page, make your desired changes and click save at the top before returning to the main panel to either restart the server, or you can use the SB reload command in-game. As for other files, the config YML file contains general options and settings that impact in-game aspects, such as the view distance setting, to determine the amount of blocks needed to activate a signboard. Others may influence what messages appear for operators or in the server's console. Inside of the locale directory from the signboard folder, there are language files. These determine how default messages appear in-game from the plugin, such as the command prompts. The most important settings are the default board line X options, since they control the basic template for all of the new boards. If Signboard isn't loading, first make sure you're running a plugin compatible server like Paper or Spigot, and that it matches the version to the one you downloaded. Once this is done, make sure Signboard is uploaded into the plugins directory and restart the server. Remember, you need to have operator privileges or permissions assigned to your account to use any plugin commands. This can be done by entering OP username in the console or using luck perms to permit your characters to use them. Of course, also go over the commands list to make sure they're being typed correctly with no formatting issues. If you have an issue with saving boards after restarting the server, then make sure you're using the sb sign attach name command. This is required for all of the changes to be saved, even after a restart. If you have a server that includes a lot of new info for players, or if you just want to have a rules section for when people first join, this plugin is everything you need and more. With how easy it is to edit the signs or NPCs, you'll have it down in no time, and soon enough, players will be able to join and see your new additions.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.